Ladies and gentlemen, the game from Argentina and Tunisia will begin in just a minute. What an exciting match. Hungary made it through to the quarterfinals, and the next one's going to be just as exciting. It's Tunisia against Argentina, and only one team can make it through to the quarterfinals. So let's find out who's going to be shouting for Tunisia. But who'll be shouting for Argentina? Okay, ladies and gentlemen, the teams are getting ready, so please be upstanding and make some London 2012 noise for the teams and give them an Olympic welcome! Oh. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the field of play, Argentina! Now please welcome to the court, Tunisia! Let's welcome the team. Argentina will start with team captain number 7, Andres Kokovsek.
On the court, colorful atmosphere.
Number 1, Matthias Carlos Schultz. Number 2, Federico Gaston Fernandez.
Argentina being introduced to the crowd ahead of the
team. Number 3, Federico Pizarro.
He'll be stepping to the 7-meter line.
Number 4, Sebastian Simone. Number 5, Pablo Sebastian Portela. Number 6, Diego Esteban Simone.
Diego Simone.
Number 8, Mariano Andres Canepa. Number 9, Leonardo Facunda Quirin. Number 10, Federico Matias Vieira. Number 11, Guido Rigobelli. Number 12, Fernando Gabriel Garcia. Number 15, Gonzalo Matias Caru. And number 17, Damian Emmanuel Migueles. The officials for Argentina, Guillermo Hector Milano, Eduardo Gabriel Gallardo, Guillermo Hector Kazan, and Carlos Eduardo Marino, Argentina.
Let's introduce the team from Tunisia. Starts with captain number 20, Heikel Meganam. Number 3, Salim Hedoui. Number 4, Amen Toumi. Number 5, Mahmoud Gabi. Number 6, Issam Tej.
Issam Tej will be the real danger man.
Number 7, Jalaluddin Touati. Number 8, Bissam Hammam. Number 9, Amin Banor. Number 10, Kamal Alouini. Number 12, Marouane Magais. Number 16, Vassim Halal. Number 17, Vail Jalous. Number 21, Anwar Ayed. And number 22, Osama Bougamni. Team officials from Tunisia, Rida Menai, Alain Portes, Sabet Mahfoud, and Naim Hamami.
The referees for today's match from Denmark, Per Olesen, and Lars Ibu Pedersen. The technical officials, the timekeeper from the Islamic Republic of Iran, Daud Tawakoli, and the scorekeeper from the Netherlands, Jan Tuik. And the IHF official, ladies and gentlemen, from Kuwait, Abu Marzouk, Nasser Abu Marzouk.
Officials, we've been time is just moments away. And this is an important match for both Argentina and Tunisia. The opening fixture in the morning between Group B challenges Hungary and Serbia. This is a battle to the sea. Who makes the final quarter-final place from Group A? Argentina, watch out for the captain, number 7, Andres Kogosek, a star player down the wing. Loves to score on the fast breaks. Quick, very wily off the ball. Guido Ricobelli will be an impact player later. The Simone brothers, 4 and 6, are the real danger men. They distribute play with the likes of number 2 and 4. 2 and 3, Fernandez and Pizarro remain. Argentina's leading scorers. Eduardo Gabriel Gallardo, coach of this Argentine men's handball team. Tunisia. Number 17, Rael Jalous. Huge jump shot that he's got. A very tall, lithe player with wonderful speed. Just 21. A real star for the future, part of the Tunisian side that finished third at the World Junior Championships in Greece just last year. Osama Bougami, the number 22, still a young winger as well. To get a nice high and attack position players. Rise from starting goal. Alain Bort, the confident news team, can get to the finals. That's what it's all about. Tunisia to qualify for the knockout stage with a draw. A better goal difference than Argentina. Ivan Dumi. Dumi with 12 goals already in this tournament. Santej and Manur are the leading scorers for Tunisia. This tournament overall, between them, 51 goals. Diego Simone has 15 goals or more from Argentina. So Marais starting goal. Schultz for Argentina. Sets of goalkeepers had top level performances against Great Britain This is a far tougher opponent with all due respect to Great Britain. They finished bottom of the group. No wins, no points. Argentina against Tunisia for a place in the quarterfinals. Argentina in the white with sky blue. Throw off against the Tunisian outfit. That is desperate for qualification to the last 8. Argentina in their Olympic debut. The first ever Olympic victory came against Great Britain, the host nation. Tunisia has never finished higher than 10th. If they make the quarterfinals, they will be guaranteed a top 8 placing. Has to be, oh, hugely Gusto Fernandez. Injured his left wrist 4 days ago. Not strapped as heavily as it was in Argentina's last outing. Turned out to be a fit to Sweden. Picked up by Megan Hammond. A good advantage being played by the referees. Megan Hammond says, thank you very much. Beat Schultz. 3 minutes gone. Tunisia lead 1-0. Caru, meanwhile, has been cautioned by the referee. Three for Argentina. Sebastian Sune. They're going down again. It's got to be used. The guilty party. Sebastian Simone, Vieira. Diego Simone. Denied again by Magais. Hedwi, playoff, Meganem. Free throw, Tunisia. Saving at over 30% in this tournament. Saving at only 20. Could be the difference for Tunisia. Certainly gives them a superior goal difference to Argentina, so a draw would be good enough if they can match Argentina goals a goal. So far, goals and nervous start in both teams. Tunisia, pop pass up, free shot effectively, and Tunisia lead by two. Doumi with a score. Better play, Ivan Doumi eventually popping the finish into Schultz's net, but it took a long time in actually getting there. It was scrappy play, desperate from Meganem. Laid it off nicely to Dej, and Dej to Doumi. Caru is off for a 2 minute suspension, out of screen though. Big line player from Argentina, he received the caution 2 minutes ago. Sebastian Simone, and in the guard area here, so here's Tunisia who has the turnover. Recovery by Jalous, who follows it up beautifully. Not convincing just yet from Tunisia, but Jalous cleans up. Really a picky spot against Schultz. Gets his opening score in this game. Expect to see this man, Morel Jalous, in the years ahead. Still in Tunisia. Like Tunisians. The Arts will receive an offer from France soon enough. He goes to go play. Mediterranean from Tunisia. We now extend their lead to four. Doumi with his second. The African champions are off to a flyer. The Pan American champions are a little shell shocked. Doumi, dangerously close to that goal line. Two-minute suspension here for Diego Simone. Didn't see the incident, but what it does mean is that for a matter of seconds, Argentina are playing with just four players. Well, that's it. On, but Vieira's recovered. Snatch the ball out of your opponent's hand like that. Mr. Gladby. Currently with Nantes in France. Vieira, Abicovelli already on. He's a good power player. Abicovelli, another save. That's Vieira's effort. Took a little deflection off the Tunisian wall, so. And Argentina have failed to put a score on the board. Riccobelli, who usually comes on later on in the match to be used as an impact player, is on, possibly with the 2-minute suspension to Diego Simone, the leading scorer for Argentina this tournament. Surely Tunisia can't go 5-0 up, can they? Turnover. Fast break. Can Argentina finally score? They do. 7 minutes and 44 seconds to get a goal. And the goal has finally come the way of Fernandez. Frederico Gaston Fernandez did some damage. Match against Great Britain. And Tunisia back out in front by 4. Meganem with the score. Effectively cancelling Fernandez's goal for Argentina. Meganem, Ian Tooney, both have 2 goals for Tunisia in the early stages. Player Jalouz with the other. Diego Simone. Can't control. Stolen by Jalouz. Turnover. Quickly forward. Hedry. Should be a follow-up if it off the woodwork. Third time lucky perhaps, and eventually it is. Well, they were lucky that the ball came back every time to a Tunisian player. Henry missed out initially. First saved by Schultz, and then off the woodwork from Toumi. Straight back to Henry, who had his second chance. Tunisia's third.
Hablamos del repliegue y no bajamos. Tres rebotes seguidos agarraron. ¿Tá? El tema defensivo no está mal, tenemos uno menos, hay que salir a chocar al 20, que jueguen los otros. ¿Tá? En el ataque denle mucha más movilidad al ataque, es muy uno contra uno sobre el par. Amplíen bien trayectorias bien amplias para poder descargar. ¿Estamos? Y después metamos la pelota adentro, viejo. Cerramos 4 lanzamientos solo, dale.
Dale, loco.
Vamos.
Dale,
dale. Contre 5, soyez un peu plus sûrs dans vos passes, hein. Elles sont un peu approximatives. Le reste, c'est bien, les gars. Continuez à plonger sur les ballons qui traînent. Hein. Et on ne s'affole pas, c'est encore long.
Arabic and French, both widely spoken in Tunisia as in much in North Africa. So, despite having a French coach, some understanding for the Tunisian main side. Mediterranean, quite as close as the Iberian Peninsula. Spain is to Morocco, just across the Strait of Gibraltar, but still not far to travel from mainland Europe. Mediterranean. Argentina have another. Trailed by only 4 now as Carroll hits from the 6-meter line. Here for Garbi, I think it is. It is Garbi. Ooh, Miguelish. Down on top of Garbi. I'm not sure why Garbi is the player who's been cautioned. Jalouz, if any player, should have been cautioned. Garbi has picked up the caution from the referee. I'm not perplexed by that either way. The caution is there. It'll count towards the team tally of caution. second yellow card to an individual player. Each of them has conceded on each of these sides so far. 10 minutes gone, Tunisia 6, Argentina 2. It took them 7 minutes and 44 seconds to open the score in the Argentines. Tunisia. Again, the Ricobelli couldn't score this time. Ricobelli, now Simone. Diego Simone will try the jump shot if he's given too much space. Ricobelli loves to go to goal. It's good to see him shooting. He doesn't have the best of scoring runs. A little push from the back from Garbi. From the Tunisian defender, Emmanuel has let his side down here. Going up for the block is one thing, fouling your opponent is another, especially when you're on a yellow card. 2 minute suspension. Now Tunisia need to play the next 2 minutes. A one player deficit. Miguelis punishes Tunisia immediately. Down by just 3 now. They were down by 5. A short while ago. How often you see 3 2-minute suspensions inside 11 minutes of a handball match. Jimmy fires into the chest of Schultz. Saved by goalkeepers can really turn the match on its head. Jalouz is back on. Wing play, Cam Pizarro. Pizarro misses out on the chance to give Argentina a fourth goal in this game. Magais trying to slow play down and get Tunisians not to rush the ball downfield again. That's very experienced head on his shoulders, Maradona Magais. 29, relatively young for international goalkeepers. Better with age. He's very much ahead on his shoulders. Tunisia push forward. 6-3. Tej will get the free throw. And the yellow card. He's not happy with the rule against. Kirin. Guilty regardless. Big push by Leonardo. Kirin. Deserved caution. Free throw Tunisia. It's Tej. Need to score in this game. This is a danger line playing as the match continues with Tej. This is what he's so good at. This time sets it up and Tunisia back in front by 4. Belief that they can do this. Tunisia has shocked the world before. They did it back in 2005 at the World Championships when they made the semi-finals. They missed out on a medal, but they placed 4th. Since then it's been their progressive downward slide in the World Championships, 11th in 2007, 17th in 2009, and 20th placing in 2011. But what a boost it would be for Tunisia if they can advance to the quarterfinals. And what an Olympic debut it would be for the Gauchos of Argentina if they can somehow turn this match around. Still plenty of time to overturn the deficit. Fernandez, the player who's touching his face. Just bumped off by Megan M, the Tunisian captain. Hey. Bont. A nervous man for now. Maybe a quarter of the way into this men's handball group game. Sebastian Simone. Taru. Diego Simone. Sebastian Simone. Taking one too many steps. This is shocking from the guys. And has an open goal effectively. That's a yellow card being issued for Jalouse, despite trying to keep Simone back. Guys, the guilty party. Oh, slipped as well. He's tried his best. And must have been lucky enough to get the 2 minute suspension. And then it ended up in the back of the Tunisian nets. Maybe. But a mistake from the goalkeeper who's been outstanding in making the saves to give Tunisia the early advantage. Tunisia lead by three. Argentina look to cut it even further here with an attack forward. Bounces, spins, and Magais deflects the ball away on the stroke of 15 minutes. A quarter of the way through the game now, and Tunisia up by three. Halfway to half time. Great spin away from his marker.
Plus les attaques là, c'est ça le problème, on les construit plus, on n'installe pas une circulation de balles, on fait des contrôles tout de suite, c'est ça qui nous met dans la merde. Reprenez notre jeu collectif les garçons, hein, en fait les mouvements qu'on a fait hier, si ça marche pas, dos dedans, on n'a pas fait dos dedans qui bouge encore, tout de suite on tente quelque chose.
El lateral, está muchas situaciones de cambio de ritmo porque ellos basculan, ajustan y no y vuelven rápido para atrás. Entonces, el doblar el pase lo vamos a agarrar a contrapierna. Estamos ordenado, metamos la pelota adentro, estábamos 5 abajo, lo pusimos en partido. ¿Estamos?
Dale. Alain Port trying to keep a very calm head on his shoulders. Tunisia's players look to be getting just a little upset with one another. You don't want to have teammates blaming one another. Dej is unhappy. There's a joke with the Danish referee a little earlier. Fernandez with a spot of bother a moment ago. Reich, Dej, senior players of the Tunisian outfit. It's a very good mix of youth and experience. Many of the young players that excelled at the World Junior Championships in Greece last year are here, led by the talent of Jalou. Skadeway goes for the score, and Tunisia take their lead out to 2 after 18 minutes. And for Argentina, it's very much a case of trying to play on the weaknesses of Tunisia. One of those weaknesses is if you can disrupt the team ethic, you can easily capitalize. Argentina do that successfully, though. The question that they will hope to answer in the remaining 32 minutes of play. Diego Simeone. Powerful effort coming in from Miguel Espin, well off target. The fast break is on here. Dumi blocks. Clemency was pushed by Diego Simeone in the first place on the near side, but Schultz with the save. Chance for Argentina to take it back to within one, and they don't make the mistake. Going to the line, Diego Simeone. He's going to rack up a tally if he continues in this vein. And what is great about the youth of Diego Simeone is this. Unlike his rather more mature brother Sebastian, who's composed in when and where to take his shots. It's very much a case of shoot wherever, whenever for Diego. Bovandi is denied now by Schultz. Tunisia can't reclaim that 2-goal advantage. A 5-goal lead that became a 1-goal lead. And Argentina, that initial lead by Tunisia was much more than an obstacle that they needed to overcome, and found it insurmountable in 20-odd minutes. But they can easily overhaul the tally by the end of this first half. They'll be looking to level things up here, and Pizarro does that. Stroke of 20 minutes. Argentina on back on level terms. 8 plays 8. Through the game, the decider in Group A to see which team advances to the quarterfinals and which team goes home. Rodney, 2 minute suspension for the winger. Second half of the game for Tunisia. Rodney, served the first 2 minute suspension. Argentina served of their 2 minute suspension simultaneously. Play it out. Too tight on the angle, and a bit of a problem here, it seems. A very delicate situation for the Tunisian 280. Missed the angle. Schultz's foot came down in the pelvic area of 280. Brazil is there. game, they do. Diego Simone, a third goal for him. And from five goals down, Argentina now lead by one. Magaish can't save anything. And he wasn't beaten for the first 7 minutes and 44 seconds. The saves have dried up since then. Hedwi. 2 minute suspension for Fernandez. Hedwi gets the call. Free throw to Tunisia, not to the 7 meter line. But it back. Free throw to Tunisia. Meganem. Bonur. It's a charging throw. Rini, he's already got one in this game. Another free throw to Tunisia. Both teams playing with five outfield players. Welcome back to sixth. Long get the shot away. Another 2 minute suspension. Gurin is off. For the next minute and a half, Argentina will play. Another player down. Great time for Tunisia to strike back and reclaim the lead. Beat Schultz. The free throw. Missed the target. Argentina celebrate because now they can count the clock down a little, and little moments like this could prove decisive in the eventual outcome of this game. Luck seemingly on the side of Tunisia at the start. It's seemingly deserted them now. Seconds left on his suspension, and Argentina running the clock down nicely. They miss out on the chance to extend the lead to two, though, as Simone fires wide. Garbi, 7 meter throw, and another 2 minute suspension. Argentina have got three outfield players as Portela is off for at least 9 seconds. They will play with only three. Fernandez, 2 minute suspension. Kerin, 2 minute suspension. Portela, 2 minute suspension. Just the fourth 2 minute suspension between the sides in the last 3.5 minutes. Salah Mugambi picked up a 2 minute suspension for Tunisia as well. Argentina, A, have conceded a 7 meter throw, and B, 9 seconds to play with three men off the court. Guys in Hedwi. Watching to one another off the ball. Schultz is beaten. It's back on level terms as Tunisia bag another. Anwar Raed. Left winger. He's a late injury call up in his first game. Gets his first goal of this game. Argentina still have two players off 2 minute suspensions. Nine plays nine, and Tunisia failed to take advantage of a player disadvantage for Argentina. Thank you. intervention coming now, this time for Tunisia. Striker, 25 minutes. This is turning out to be a match of ill discipline. It should be a game of who wants it more. It's not happening. The captain is off for Tunisia. They were playing with just three outfield players. Nine plays, nine. Once again, very low scoring opening half. It's a decisive match, 5 minutes to go to the break. Diego Simonet being charged off and denied by Malaise. Save is made, ball ricochets off the referee as well. Way back onto the park now after the suspension of Portela is up now. They take the advantage though, despite being a player down. Meganem is off for another minute and 10 odd seconds. Tunisia, the first to double figures. Schultz said the wrong way. In the opening half alone. And it's still not complete. There's no chance for more. This is where the has been going. Could still happen. A good score, but clutched his ankle immediately. Pizarro. Well, for Argentina's sake, I hope this is not serious. Awkwardly, perhaps. Federico Pizarro. Ooh, that should have been called as a goalkeeper throw. He was in the goal area when he took off. Can't do that. Federico Pizarro. Lucky to come away with a score. 3.5 minutes to go to time. To take the lead, and they do so with a perfectly placed effort by Pizarro. That ankle is fine. Diego Simonet, a little pop-up, great assist. Cheeky finish, but a classic finish as well. Only 21 goals in the opening half. Argentina up by one. 23rd shot goal, they've scored in less than half. So have Tunisia. Of the day for the keepers, saving at 38%. Schultz saving at 31%. All right. Meganem. Powerful effort from Meganem. His experience telling once again. He said he will retire after London 2012. Now 35 years old. To captain Tunisia to a quarterfinal place at least. Argentina get another from the line. Carew, 2 minutes to play and Argentina up by one. 2 minutes of this opening half to play in a Group A decider. Final day of the men's preliminary round action in the London 2012 men's handball competition. Group B has been confirmed, who will advance? Group A is yet to be decided. And here for Gandhi. So Gandhi. So Camille Luini. Thank you. again. Good score from Tunisia. Clever play, quick hands. Arini. Bounced off Argentinian defender a short while ago. Gets the score. Passes by Caro and then Schultz. No defense. 12 plays 12. An intense affair at the copper box. Competition format changes slightly with the knockout stages for the men's competition. Pizarro won't get a shot. And, 2 minute suspension. Darby again. Seconds to play in the opening half, 12 plays 12. So the handball competition. We'll play here at the top of the box. Men's quarterfinals, semi-finals and finals will be played at the basketball arena. The women's semi-finals and finals will be played there. It's the women's semi-finals to host after this. Possibly a pentathlon action at the top of the box. For the Paralympic Games from Goldball. Diego Simonet off the post. Free throw Argentina. The clock running down. 5 seconds. So the referee is not happy with the area. A sweaty patch just outside the goalkeeper's area. Eduardo Gallardo trying to draw attention to the scoreboard. Saying, lads, 4 seconds left to play. Caru might just go for goal. And we'll look to set up Sebastian Simone. Will it be? Denied by Magais. Keeps it out as we go to half time with the sides locked at 12. And Argentina will feel very much inspired by the way they came back. They were 5 goals down to this Tunisian outfit after 7.5 minutes, but came back in. A decent run of scores. Magais' goal saving ended up drying up slightly. Argentina 12, Tunisia 12. With just half an hour remaining in this Group A decider. Winner goes to the quarterfinals. Tunisia some nervous moments. Half an hour remains in the playing time for one of these teams. 12 for the other. It is a date with destiny. They're level pegging at the break. If they remain level pegging at the end of the 60 minutes, it'll be Tunisia who advance to the quarterfinals for the first time in their Olympic history. Argentina. A victory that can see them through. Tunisia's goal difference is superior to that of Argentina. Bielish, the player loves to come in on the impact, operated so well as well. This team's having to make injury replacements. Oh, 32-year-old Alvarez.
Argentina!
And advance to the next stage of this tournament. That is the quarterfinals. The quarterfinals getting underway. 2 days' time. The Tunisian fans believe you've come to witness an historic moment. One of these teams, Diego Esteban Simonet, he's been the player who's really been a thorn in the side of opposition defences. He's scored 3 goals, but he's taken 7 shots and really proved instrumental. Tej, surprisingly, has yet to score for Tunisia in this game, but even in his 3 efforts with Almini. But he's some vital saves. 6 saves for Schultz in the opening half. 6 saves for Magais in the opening half. Magais with a better start. Tunisia rushed out into a 5-0 lead. Minutes of the game. So Tunisia, who need only a draw to advance to the quarterfinals for the first time in their Olympic history, throw off in the second half. Argentina need a win to get the quarterfinal stages in what is their debut Olympic campaign. Sign early on, Amin Benoud, the 22-year-old, just dropped the ball. An experience perhaps set to creep in. Both these teams have only beaten Great Britain. They both lost to France, to Iceland and to Sweden. Around the outside, and Magais with a save. Goalkeeper throw it'll be. A minute's gone in the second half. Very early stages, still plenty to play for. Question is, who is mentally stronger? So the conclusion of the 2 minute suspension for Mahmoud Garbi. 2 seconds away, and then Tunisia will be at full strength, and despite being a player down, managed to score. They lead. Opening salvo in the second half, fired by Tunisia. 13-12 they're up as Alouini gets his 5th of the game. His 4th rather. No player from either side has chipped in with 4 goals in the game. Closely contested affair. Only a couple of players really contributing to the scoreboard. It's a turnover from Diego Simonet. Pedri couldn't make headway. And summed off now. Tunisia multiple substitutions. Time off for something. The line referee has spotted something. trying to get play back on the way, but they can't just yet. Tunisia in possession there as time is back on. The African champions up by one. They were up by five. Let that lead slip. Benur, line play, and Issam Dej can't score his first in this game. Fast break was on. Needed to be weighted properly, and Schultz a little too heavy on it. Issam Dej going to the line. Shot saved by Schultz, and this time Schultz can't make the save. Good follow-up efforts. Kamel Alwini now does get his fifth. As Tunisia extend their advantage to 14. Argentina remains scoreless in the second half. Alwini broke, spun, falling shots, beat Schultz. Tunisia 14, Argentina 12. I can tell you that Gonzalo Carru is sitting out a 2-minute suspension now. So discipline, the determining factor in the outcome of this match, perhaps the sixth of the game for Argentina. Tunisia had four. Garbi has served one too many. Good shot from Argentina this time. Power effort coming in over the top from Federico Pizarro. Back to within a one-goal game. The guys couldn't keep it out. Now the worry for both players is that Garbi has served two two-minute suspensions and Carru is currently serving his second two-minute suspension, so Portela makes the block. One more two-minute suspension for either one of Carru or Garbi, and will no longer be available to play in this match. The little bounce through, and a big powerful effort from Issam Dej. Usually the danger man for Tunisia up front, the line player gets it right for the first time in the game. Issam Dej has been distributing the ball nicely, but he's been very closely marked by the likes of Fernandez, Portela and Quirin. Finally breaks through, Tunisia lead by two, first to 15. Issam Dej celebrated his birthday at the Olympic Games. Disappointing result on his birthday though, as Tunisia lost out to Sweden by 7 goals, 28-21 in their opening encounter of London 2012. Mugambi is on now, the young winger. He's number 22, Miguelish looks to distribute. Sebastian Simone looks to find Rico Belli. He'll go for goal almost certainly from just about anywhere. Is there space? And Magais makes another save. Argentina with the recovery, Riccobelli. That was a great piece of acrobatic turnover from Fernandez to win the ball back for Argentina. Scrambling dive while in the air, palmed it back towards his half of the court. Recovered by Riccobelli for Argentina. Kogovcek is on the wing. Loves to hit on the fast break. Riccobelli held by Hedri. Can't be doing that. Another 2-minute suspension coming here. Unless something changes very quickly, Magais with another save. And Sebastian Simone can't quite breach the Tunisian keeper's defence. Tunisian keeper stands firm. His defensive wall not. Gaps opening up just slightly. Schultz with 7 saves in the game. Magais, the Tunisian keeper, with 8. Too many turnovers for both sides. Way too many 2-minute suspensions as discipline continues to plague those sides that do not play in Europe. And that's a very, very poor effort indeed from Kamel Alwini, a 24-year-old Club Africain star. Hit the target at least. Well off target. Pizarro, he'll go for goal. And Pizarro is denied. Good time to save, but a free throw for Argentina. Beaded somehow, perhaps, or jersey tagging going on by Bugarni. He's already served a 2-minute suspension as well, the young winger. Surprised that Wael Jalouz has played so little time in this match for Tunisia. Jalouz still only 21, he's got a lot to learn, but he stands 6'6" tall and he's a big power player. Riccobelli sends my guys the wrong way and Argentina take this to a one goal game. So confident, Riccobelli. That in a number of ways, but perhaps it's best to let the pictures do the talking. Riccobelli, absolute delight. Will be delighted in 23 minutes' time. Meganem gets another score. Tunisia back in front by two. All it needs is one very simple passage of play that can see a two-goal switch. One save by the keeper when it should have been a score from, say, a fast break. Score upfield on the opposite side can turn a game on its head in a matter of seconds. This is not a comfortable lead, and you'd rather be in front. Argentina would need three goals to advance to the quarterfinals. The turnover is on, looking for the fast break, not to come. Still pushing forward, Alwini back with Hedri and connected by Visamma. Samtej to the far side flank, the right wing, Jalildin Toati. When he started playing at the age of 11, he was a youngster when he saw it on television in Tunisia, decided to take up the game and has had great success. Banur again, poor handling, but he manages to recover. Good save from Schultz, turnover, the break is on. Gogolsek wants to distribute to Pizarro, but he was a little undecided, took one too many steps. And a turnover conceded. Four steps. And the referee spot on with the call. Oh, Schultz knows, shouldn't have done better. Too many steps. The Argentine defence, and that's a relatively easy score. Meganim tossed it in, lacking in power, but he's managed to squeeze it through. Tunisia back in front by three. Argentina feeling just a little down and out. You see passages of play with several goals, and then a few passages of play with not many. Wayward shooting. The discipline is a little more from both sides. 2 minute suspensions in the last few minutes. Oh, the only player in the second half to be cautioned, to be sent to the stands. What a disappointment. I can't watch. 10 minutes gone in this second half. We're two-thirds of the way through this game. And the call from Mam Tej to their goalkeeper, my guys, is don't toss it upfield. Don't get a little heated and send it forward. Alain Porte, coach of Tunisia, he won a bronze with France as a player back in 1992, 20 years on. He's looking to guide the African champions into the last eight for the first time in their history. And that is a big score. Tunisia lead by four. Big power play from Kamel Alwini. And a timeout being called, not surprisingly, by Argentina. Bueno,
ya no podemos levantar 5, que nos vaya a 4 por forrada nuestra. ¿Está? Vamos a ir, Andrés va a ir al avanzado. Ante la transformación vas a ir con el lateral que quede. Dejemos al zurdo que juegue. ¿Está? Y lo demás compacto, muchachos. No pueden hacer los goles de mierda como ese recién. ¿Listo? En el ataque, denle continuidad y vamos a resolver rápido. Dale.
Dale. Ok, les garçons, Peut-être ils vont changer le gardien. Regardez bien. Hein. Allez, allez, allez.
Rémi, Rémi. Quand il pose l'aïssable, fixe extérieur. Double strict. Quand là, double strict. Quand il pose l'aïssable, nous j'ai mal fait extérieur. Tout le monde est plus que
instructions from the coach in French, instructions from the captain in Arabic. But as it stands, Tunisia outscoring Argentina by 6-2 in the second half after it was level pegging at the break. So Tunisia leading 18-14. They're up by 4 and Argentina need to win to advance to the quarterfinals. Alouini and Meganem both chipping in with 5 goals for the African champions. Argentina goals distributed fairly evenly, but Pizarro leading the way with 4. Diego Simone with 3. Caru, Migueles both with 2. Who wants to take responsibility here? Diego Simone. Caru's got onto the line. Play on is the call, but this time Mum with the infringement. So free throw Argentina. Pizarro, Diego Simone, against the goal area, as Diego Simone brings Argentina back into it, reduces the deficit to 3, and still a very, very worried set of Argentine fans. That is a wonderful little active control. The brothers combine. Oh, splendid. Diego received after his older brother Sebastian just popped it over the Tunisian defensive line, caught it in the air, released it on target before he landed. So it's great skill to execute it. It looks so good when you get it right. Tunisia. Interval now with a little more purpose, but communication lacking, and Aluini's pass out for Dwati is unsuccessful. Gorosek saying run off, don't get substituted. Zaro is on. Hedwig, as Pizarro takes the shot, it's not going to count, but Hedwig is going to just give a verbal warning here. Still mopping up of Sweat, my guy stays in goal. It's a nervous affair for both these teams. Alain Porte will be believing his side can maintain their lead, their advantage, while Gallardo will be desperate for his side to claim the advantage, claim the win, breakthrough, an historic achievement for either one of these teams. Whoever advances to the quarterfinals, as a power effort comes over the top, and Argentina, down by 4 a couple of minutes ago, are now back to within 2 of Tunisia. 18 plays 16, Tunisia still lead over the Pan American champions as Sebastian Simone gets another score. Clever on the angle, nice mark near post. Simone went back post. Henry serving a 2-minute suspension now. On target is Banur. Amin Banur. Tunisia up by 3, Argentina need 4. Argentina must win this match to advance to the quarterfinals. Pizarro, Sebastian Simone, Diego Simone. Out to the wing. Gorosek is denied by Magais. So what's happening here? And now a few angry words from Sebastian Simone. Protests to the referee. His teammates trying to calm him down. And the Danish referee is having none of it. Going for the shot over the top and look for the pass to Kogovsek was taken down. Garbi is saying, get up, mom. Player went in for the block, I fear. Oof. With a hand in the face. Not sure it was overly, if it was deliberate at all. But he certainly caught him, and I can understand Simone's protests. Should have at least been a free throw to Argentina. Kogovsek. Shot saved. He captains the team now. 17 years he played for the national team before he was awarded the captaincy under his Kogovsek. Tunisia up by three. They're a player down. Suspension of Slim Khedwi. Free throw Tunisia. Wild shot, well wide of the target from the captain, Meganem. So managed to score five in this game. Only firing at 63% though, but what is good is that he's taken the responsibility of the goal scoring on his shoulders. And 7 meter throw is the call now for Argentina. Just over 15 minutes gone in this second half. Just gone three quarters of the way into this game, and Imam concedes the 7 meter throw. Fernandez beats my guys. Argentina back to within two. Consummate finish from the consummate professional. Fernandez, the Argentinian players who's left the country to play abroad, currently in Spain. Tunisia back to their full complement of players as Banour tried for the little spin shot around the goalkeeper. 2 minute suspension coming here now. And frustration for Karu because this is disqualified. He will not be able to play any further part in this game. The Argentine line player has picked up a third 2 minute suspension. Well, it wasn't a very big push, but it was a push, and Karu must now leave the court. He can play no further part in this game. He can't even watch it courtside. The IHF official tells him he needs to leave the court area. Tears, the emotion of it all, it's what it means to the players. Shaking, and he must leave the court area. Sentiment cast aside. Tunisian bench being told to calm down. Shortly disqualified after a little push. Tunisia in front. Team plays 17. Saddle cutting through, hacked down, and that's going to be a 2 minute suspension. Clotheslining the opposition, and this might just be a straight red. It is. Duetti. At the very least, it was going to be a 2 minute suspension. Straight red card. And Duarte's off. Not exactly protesting his innocence, but that was cynical. Very cynical. And we've seen two red cards in the space of 30 odd seconds of play. Oh, he put the elbow up. Closed line, Pizarro. Cynical, malicious. You don't want to see it in the game. Jalildin Duarte is off. And rightly so. It's been a very, very difficult match for the Danish referees, Olsen and Pedersen. And overall, I'd say they've handled things very well. Both these sides are desperate to make it through to the quarterfinals. A win here means a quarterfinal place, an historic moment for handball in their respective countries. That is uncalled for. has to leave the whole court area, but he can't watch from the stands either, Tuaiti. Diego Simone. Free throw for Argentina. And the referee, this is good to see from Danish referees, just saying to Diego Simone, we know it was a foul, don't play it. Don't make more of it than you already did. It's a good warning, solid warning. They'll spot the infringements, they'll call it. Kovacek denied. Turnover conceded, good save from my guys. Tunisia up by two. 13 minutes remain for this all-important final, quarter-final place. It's a Group A clash. Iceland, France, Sweden already guaranteed a place. Great Britain guaranteed to finish bottom. One of these teams played in the quarterfinals. Will it be Tunisia? Will it be Argentina? At the moment, the African champions are on top and they go three clear. First to 20. Big, powerful jump shot straight over the center. Almini gets another. Sixth of the game. Argentina will be allowed to bring another player back on. Caru's suspension is up, but he will not be available for the remainder of this match. And they are back to their full complement of players. Tunisia still down. Pizarro off the post. Should have done better with a falling jump shot. Did so well to get to the breakthrough line on the 6 meter. Spun away from his marker, took the shot, beat the goalkeeper, but couldn't beat the woodwork. Rice has stood big, tall throughout the game. Argentina know the longer they go without making up or chipping away at the Tunisian lead, the more difficult it will be for them to try to overturn the deficit. They must win. A draw is good enough for Tunisia, so they can concede three. But they go up by four now. Issam Tej turns away, takes the shot. Expect the timeout to be called anytime soon. Goalkeeper substitution. They really are throwing everything forward. To the 7 meter line we go. And Diego Simone, shaking his head. The emotion is absolutely palpable. Going for another score, just backing into him. Came down uncomfortably. Back up. This is a real star for the future, just 22 years old. He already plays in France with Yves and his brother. Down by four. Sees the lighter side of it. It's impeded by Amin Toumi. To the 7 meter line. Tunisia's substitute keeper, the only Esperance player in this lineup. Hilal on to save and can't make the save for Tunisia. Argentina back to within three. Federico Fernandez, not to be confused with the Jerome Fernandez of France, gold medalist who missed out on the latter stages of the Beijing campaign after breaking his wrist. Tunisia pushing for another, it's a turnover. Sylvain Banour thought he had scored. 10 minutes to play, Tunisia up by three. Quarter-final decider. Winner stays in the competition, loser goes home. A draw good enough for the African champions. Argentina through Pizarro. Now Sebastian Simone. Bolovsek cuts back inside. Trying to bounce it through. Free throw Argentina. They need to up the urgency in this game. Pizarro. Simone looks for a way through. Still free throw Argentina. Even the body language of the Argentinian players suggested that they were lucky to come away with that call. Henry shares a laugh with the referee. Just over 20 minutes gone in the second period. Tunisia really need to watch their discipline in defence. Getting charged off the ball by Santej. Fired and denied by Magais. Sebastian Simone said somebody needs to take the shot. Tried it and was beaten. Magais up to the challenge. 11 saves in the game. Schultz has 9, saving at 30%. Magais 11 saves at 39%. Tunisia now are surely putting this game beyond Argentina. Just over 8 minutes to play, and Argentina need to make up a 5-goal difference. They are down by 4 goals, but they must win. Alwini, the 7th goal from 8 efforts in the match. Argentina gets something back. Vieira. He's got a left arm that works like a slingshot. Sebastian Simone fed him, stepped inside, went to the line, took the shot and beat Magai's back post. 22 plays 19. 22 minutes gone. 8 minutes remaining. In a very tense finish. Tej. Mugandi. Tej. Pick the ball, Tez tried to swing it out to the wing. Took a little tip of an Argentine defender, so taking possession here, Tunisia. Sweet spot being locked up. Expect a timeout to be called anytime soon. Argentina already one timeout in this half. Tunisia yet to call it, but it should be coming. Tunisia can see the turnover, the captain Meganem. Argentina to make it an interesting game now. Take it to 20. Argentina 20, Tunisia 22. They are still not down and out. There's work to be done yet. But Diego Simone says, I will fight to the very end. 7 minutes to play, Argentina need to make up a 2-goal deficit, score one more than Tunisia at least, and the timeout is now being called. Apparently, do you want it?
Garçon. Hey. Oh, Wilson, Wilson. Faut continuer comme ça. Issam, il va jouer un peu face au but. Un peu face au but. D'accord, Issam? Et tu peux jouer un contre un, hein, tu peux y aller, d'accord? Mais pas tout de suite, installez la circulation avec Issam à 4 retours. Ensuite, il y a Heikel ou Kamel qui rentre. Plutôt Heikel, c'est mieux. Hein, d'accord? Et après, les garçons, il faut bien bouger dedans. Il faut bien bouger, ok? Être disponible, on va trouver, ça va s'ouvrir. C'est... On ne peut pas annoncer quelque chose de précis. Il faut jouer avec sa tête. Et combat repli défensif jusqu'au bout, les garçons. Allez, allez, allez.
Back on. Less than 7 minutes to play. Diego Simone has led the charge for Argentina. As Kamel Alwini has kept this Argentinian side at bay. Tej, Banur. Tej, going for the goal himself. Simone was impeded, but a turnover conceded. Tunisians, a little play acting going on, maybe. Referees have been spot on with their calls throughout this match, almost without fail. Argentina only 9 turnovers, that's a pretty decent return in a match of such significance for them. But the discipline is horrid. 7 2-minute suspensions, 1 disqualification. Tunisia 5 2-minute suspensions and 1 red card straight for Doherty. Vieira bags it. Argentina make it a one-goal game. Nervous moments for both Tunisia and Argentina now. Who has the psychological edge? An Argentine squad, much like the Tunisians, a blend of youth and experience. Youngsters like Diego Simeone and Federico Fernandez, and some of the more experienced players like 38-year-old Andres Kovacic, after 20 years nearly as part of the national team. Gonzalo Caru has already received a disqualification in this game, and to the 7-meter line we go. 5 minutes to play and Tunisia have a call in their favour. Dej being denied, and you can pick any one of three Argentines who infringed somehow. Dej taking the shot. Alain Port says this is just fanciful, a real joke. This is the 34-year-old Anwar Anya Ayed, called in to replace Marwan Sharif. To leave injured and misses out. Chance to give Tunisia a two-goal advantage again and make it really difficult for Argentina. Smacks the head, Doherty. By rights, he shouldn't be watching. Rosie and Garou remain in positions where they can watch what is happening. Argentina being spurred on by their fans, the Pan American champions. Denied, follow-up effort, denied again. Recovery by Tunisia, Magais with a double save. Says, what more do I need to do? Now let's go and do the business upfield. Magais saving at 38% in this game. Is that good enough to give Tunisia their first ever appearance in the quarterfinals of an Olympic Games? It's only their third ever appearance. 7 meter throw in the act of shooting. Amin Banur was brought down by Sebastian Simone. Now who will take the 7 meter throw? There seems to be little time in eventually deciding. Before Ayman Toumi took the ball, and now Alouini saying, I want it. I would give it to Alouini. He's the man on form, but certainly not making a mistake this time. The 22-year-old right winger shoots with the left. Ayman Toumi gives Tunisia a two-goal advantage again. 3.5 minutes to play for a place in the quarterfinals now. Vieira, Sebastian Simone, Diego Simone. Argentina will run themselves ragged in the remaining minutes of this game. They will not believe they are out of it. Tunisia desperately desire a place in the quarterfinals. Big save by Magais. He's really come to the party. Free throw to Argentina regardless. Diego Simone, such credit to the youngster. He has really pushed for every attack. Taken the game to Argentina on numerous occasions. Sebastian Simone goes down. No foul committed. A medical timeout is going to be called here. Just under 3 minutes to play. Is there a push by Henry? Some referees might have called that. Ooh, Sebastian Simone is just... left foot is slid out from under him as well, and I think his face has gone into the knee of Mum. Very tough players, the Simone brothers. They give it their all, and they really have done throughout this Olympic campaign. Goals between the brothers in this tournament so far. As they led the Argentine charge, looking to defend now. 2.5 minutes remaining, a medical timeout being called. Banur, the player who's gone down. Sebastian Simone ever involved, this time tonguing down his opponent. Banur, Tej. Mam dances his way through, but it's a turnover conceded. Argentina are on the break. Look to hit. Can they score? Magais denies them again. Break is on. Calming them down. Call from the match to say, hold on to it. Hold on to it. Do not send it upfield. Magais with the all-important save at the back. Schultz has made 9 saves in the game for Argentina, saving at 30%, but a 39% saving rate for Magais. 13, and that is now surely beyond Argentina. 3-goal lead for Tunisia with less than 2 minutes to play. Banur with the score from the 6-meter line, bottom right. Seconds remain. Date with destiny awaits. 2 minute suspension for Hamam. Still plenty to play for in this game. Tunisia are up by 3. Argentina need to win by at least 1. So need to score 4 allotted of goals in less than 90 seconds. I would suggest it's game over. It's not impossible.
Una solución rápida y después tomamos personal. Leo queda de libero, ¿está? Sin falta, si tiene que avanzar, que vayan por afuera. Estamos, tenemos que recuperar la pelota. Vamos, dale, dale.
On reste bien groupé. Attention, ils vont refaire pressing à 5 contre 6. Il faut donner le ballon à Ekel ou Kamel. Ils essaient d'avancer en dribblant et s'écarter. Dès qu'ils arrêtent de dribbler, il faut leur donner une solution. D'accord.
Portela. Frustration building for Argentina. Theo's on. Seems to be endorsed as goalkeeper. Nice, saving at 39%. Theo's been on for some while. Schultz saves at 30%. Theo's yet to make a save. Argentina find the back of the net. Big shot over the top from Diego Simone. They're trying to hurry up play here, Argentina. Be able to force Tunisia into taking the ball upfield with a great deal of urgency. They will finish this match with only 5 outfield players, Tunisia. A little is being made of that by Aluini. Clearly committing the foul, tonguing on the player. Free throw Tunisia, they lead by 2. It's been a very tense finish, but Argentina at times have let themselves down. Tunisia have not exactly covered themselves with glory. Neither side has, with a number of disciplinary infringements. Turnovers have been limited from both sides. 45 seconds remaining in the game. Tunisia up by 2, and a draw will be good enough for the African champions, which almost certainly now guarantees the game to the North Africans.
Il n'y a plus refus de jeu. Il n'y a plus refus de jeu. On a tiré au but. D'accord. Écoutez, disponible. Issam, tu vas te jouer à 6 mètres, toi. Quand il va. Ouais, mais assez vite, il va falloir qu'il aille dedans pour faire un coup franc. Oui, mais assez vite. Il va falloir qu'on te donne la balle à 6 mètres, que tu te fasses attraper pour faire un coup franc, d'accord? Ok, on assure le repli, les gars, on assure le repli à bloc.
J'essaye pour un de les élèves, je shoot. Mets sous touche. Allez, il se dit. J'essaye pour un de les élèves. Mets sous touche. Hâte à plus pour un de 6 mètres, je shoot.
Yalla!
Tourne!
Yalla! Yalla!
Eduardo Gabriel Gallardo, I fear that his Olympic campaign is over. Argentina are down by 2 goals, 45 seconds remaining. And this has been a match of great intensity. He's told and illustrated by a number of moments of ill discipline. Manoud looks to move it forward with purpose. Here's Dej. Tunisia running the clock down, takes the effort wide, goalkeeper throw. Not enough time now for Argentina, but they send it forward regardless. They're playing for pride now. See if they can snatch a draw against the African champions, at least for the final few seconds. Good score. It's a one-goal game. Back to the line they go. Argentina saying, let's get this started. 15 seconds remain. Over the top. Tunisia simply holding on to possession. Do not want to concede a turnover, at least. On the line. Chance for Tunisia to wrap it up. Beautifully done. And Tunisia are through to the quarterfinals of the men's handball team for the first time in their Olympic history. It's an historic day for the African champions. The North Africans have done it with a very late score from Ayman Toumi. It's been a great day for the likes of Kamel Alouini in particular, who chipped in with seven big goals to give Tunisia what is ultimately a two-goal lead over Argentina with the final few seconds remaining. Big steal right at the end, and this is how Tunisia wrapped it up. A date with destiny awaits. They finished fourth in their group, Group A, but they are quarter-finalists and a top-eight ranking, hoping to prove that their fourth place, in 2005 was not a fluke. It's a great mixture of youth and experience for Tunisia. Players from the 2005 World Championship semi-finalists, but they've also got players from the World Junior Championship bronze medalists of last year. And that blend of youth and experience has worked today. They've beaten Argentina after three losses out of three. They ended up coming back with consecutive victories. They have a Great Britain and Argentina to advance to the quarterfinals for the first time in their history. Agony for Argentina, it's ecstasy for Tunisia.